Good day, my adequate and absolutely sane товарищes from the English-speaking part of YouTube. It's me, your loyal friend Balbergiano. Sorry for my crooked accent, I just trying to sound like truly European British tea eater whom learned English by watching The Wolf Creek. And today I want to tell you about glorious Slavic video game based on adaptation of The Fellowship of the Ring, which is called Bratva and Koltso. It can be translated as Gang and the Ring, Chumps and the Ring, or Russian Village Boys and the Ring. This game was made by Gaijin Entertainment, yeah, those boys who created War Thunder and Cross Out. But truly author and scenario maker of this masterpiece is Dmitry Goblin Pучков, who also known by his YouTube channel Some Doubtful Sayings.
Малолетние дебилы. Это малолетние дебилы.
And truly human being. A long time ago of Russian history, when Putin was real, first movie was released, and Dmitry decided to create a funny adaptation of the Tolkien legacy and sell it on the bootleg DVD discs. He filled his version with a lot of Russian jokes, Soviet references,
Бандерлог. Призрак коммунизма.
Popular music. And another strange shit that can be understood only by high-leveled Slavs.
Хорошо. Я буду работать на тебя, проклятый капиталист.
The whole Sam Boltman translated all three movies, wrote three books by his adaptations, and wised up Gaijins to create for him two games based on that weird, perverted Tolkien world. Honestly, I did not expect that game will launch on my modern PC, but Slavic technologies may surprise you. In the beginning, we can see creator's logo, logo of Goblin's personal translation studio, and epic game intro. Anyway, I cannot show you all because of the copyright music, but I will just put my own version of suitable music and also will try to translate you Russian versions of heroes' names, because they're a little bit funny.
Thank you.
There are 11 levels and 7 playable characters. Plus, there is a bonus character, but nobody cares. Before every level, Дмитрий Пучков explains you what is going on here.
На секретную встречу с Федором Пендельф отправил своего верного помощника, бомжа-агронома.
And you can understand what he thinks about people who don't like his game. In the first level, we take on the role of the agronome son of the agroprom, who is just trying to save Fyodor Baggins from pedo sailors.
Немедленно отпустите этого замечательного карапуза, грязные педофилы! Отныне он мой!
That's what we call truly Slavic fairy tale.
А вот стиль пьяный красный командир!
Yep, this is a sound of this game. Only imagine original movie with this kind of music. Gameplay reminds me The Return of the King. I think that Gaijin decided to bring here a simple version of that gameplay style, because anyway nobody will play it except these handsome ребятишки.
Крепче держи портки, Фёдор!
After Pedo Sailor's genocide, we are being attacked by Urkis.
Вы кто тут такой отважный? Мочи всех подряд!
The word Urka is called Russian prisoners. Дмитрий Пучков decided to transform Saruman's Urukhai into autistic hobo jailers, because he was a ment in the past. That's why main evil dudes in his world are criminal распиздяйс. Few dead Urkis after, Fyodor ran away in the toilet. I don't know why, maybe he is my fan and it reminds him my YouTube channel. Of course, I easily killed all enemies and saved this precious карапуз.
Лови, морячок! Я вижу, ты сильно напуган, карапуз!
After every level, we can upgrade our character by spending points that we earned. This is more and more looks like the Return of the King game. In the next level, we can play by Fyodor or Senya.
Фига, Михалыч! Кэш раскидан! Похоже, с золотом! Сеня, гнида! Все золото мое! Я начальник! Кому сказано? Что нашел? Давай сюда!
Still looks much more Slavic and fantasy than The Witcher by Netflix. There are not much more to do. Our main target are gold coins and dirty shit covered ghosts. Soon Senya ran away and left Fyodor alone. In original story, Frodo was a good loyal friend, but in here, he is a greedy piece of debiloid. That's why he can't run away and left Senya, because Senya stole some gold rubles. Oh shit, please don't kill me! I don't want to start all this level again and stay here too long, otherwise I will become more retard. Here we go! We in a Russian crypt. Just look at these little details. Are these runes? Wow! This attention to detail is still better than in Kojima games, especially MGS4 that is literally a MRE filled with rotten badger shit. Finally we find Senya.
Ты чё тут разлёгся, толстый? Не прикидывайся!
Фёдор Михайлович, я видел мёртвых людей!
The rest part of level we are doing the same thing. Kill Urkis ghosts and try to stay alive.
Senya, ты что, без трусов?
In next level, game becomes much more interesting.
Уважаемый! Гадить можно только в сортире! А ну марш на очко!
We need to play as agronome and protect Fyodor from Nazi goals. Дмитрий Пучков was a Soviet person in the past. That's why evil guys in his world are criminals. And Germans. Agronom fires his torch and banishes evil German Nazis in the toilet. Game is good and quests are interesting. But anyway, this level is short as average Russian's life.
Ну назад, кому сказано? Фёдор, это одна из моих любимых шуток. Сейчас жахнет и всех обдаст.
Прикольно, прикольно, сейчас жахнет.
Dear viewers, you can rejoice! Now we can play as Baralgin and Kigdelf. Of course, I will play as Old Ment, because in this game he unbalanced just the Nietzsche's Übermensch.
Гиены алкоголики!
Now our main enemy are strange Mongolian dogs, who want to bite our ancient wizard ass. But unfortunately for them, we know Soviet kung fu techniques. Just look here. This is a local joke. The horse grain station named as the Ash Grey Gelding looks funny and aesthetic, but our calmness was not long. Doggies decided to eat Carapuzzi's butthole because it tastes like teen spirit. After heroically rescue, we killed one retro German, ran through fantasy Slavic village, and level finally ended. Ah! Fifth level. That's where the trouble began. Right now I want to play as Baralgin. Yep. And protect our base by killing 100 of barking dolphins.
Волк, это тот же собак, только невкусный. Но на шаверму все равно сгодится.
All I can tell you that it wasn't easy. First of all, there are a lot of these dogs. Secondly, sometimes they're falling from the sky right on my Jewish head. What's wrong with developers of this glorious game? Third, I need to protect every part of our Avengers team from retarded Scooby-Doos. After 100 dead animals, we have been attacked by Germans. And after 10 dead Germans, we need to kill another 40 doggos. Jesus Christos, I'm tired of this. Can we just go to the next level? Now we are going to Umoria. I chose Lagavas for this bad trip. Especially it's funny because our partner Givi Zurabovich Tseriteli. Oh, these typical dwarves names. There are nothing special at this level. We are killing Urkis and having some fun.
Lagavas зарежет вас.
But at the end we fight against Loch Ness.
Loch Ness.
Ну и где этот лох?
I can't tell that he is hard enough. All you need to do is to cut his testicles and shoot right in his face.
Да, хороший был парень Гиви. Нельзя его так бросать. Кто-нибудь, снимите сапоги и вырвите золотые коронки.
There are a few levels to go. And to be honest, they are not easy. Just like unvaccinated kids being. Our gang trying to hide themselves in Umoria. But Senya, as always, acts like a typical коси Поша.
Ты кому сигналишь, сволочь?
At this level I'll try to play as Givi, and you know what? He is awesome and unbalanced just like Kigdelf, because he fights like little ancient Soviet harvest machine. After 30 of dead Urkis, some mummy trolls came in. They're a little bit stronger than average enemy in this game, but Givi can handle this. Yet giant mummy troll arrives. He successfully destroys my ебало and compels me to restart level with upgraded Baralgin. After successful battle, our heroes understood that their squad and enemy horde are not equal. And the only way to win is to exhaust enemy by running. Now we take the role of Fedor. This level separated on two parts. First we fight together against Urki. Till collapse happens. Banderlog appears at the party. Gigdalf distracts him, everyone run away, and Fedor with Senya fall into the dead dwarf's basement. Here we meet our new enemy. Urk version of Bruce Campbell. These enemies are not stronger or weaker than average enemy is, but what I really understood is that they are heckin' annoying. Oh look! Gigdalf fights against Banderlog. But don't worry, soon we will take part in the jolly wally action.
No, that's the worst part of this level because of Urki's archers who brutally tearing apart Fedor's pink butthole.
But next happens something even worse.
Блин, ну вот где они все болтаются?
Вот вы где, карапузы!
Агроном, а где же Пендальф?
Федор, ты только не переживай. Я видел, как Пендельфа порвало на куски и сожрало страшное чудовище, которое потом спрыгнуло в пропасть со всеми нашими деньгами.
Ну чё, наглый был старикан. Зато теперь я точно начальник.
After Chim had left Kigdalf and Umodia, they made a camp. But again, Fjodor decided to screw everything up by eating illegal mushrooms, which are not illegal, but rotten and tastes like ipecac for butt. Therefore, he started run from place to place and shot every corner with juicy nuclear diarrhea. For our heroes, nothing left but rescue this hobbit ебанат.
Китай, гады, дрова гоните!
You may think that this is funny, and maybe you're right, till happened something sad. Бралгин is dead.
Крепкий был мужик, но наковальня оказалась крепче.
At the next level we can understand what really happened with this drama hero.
Не бойся, малыш, это будет не больно.
Смотри, паровоз летит. Сейчас я тебе покажу, что такое боль.
Ах ты, крысёныш поганый, гнида казематная! Мне все равно не больно!
Ты глянь, братан, как он интересно стоит!
This level sucks and annoying as Nilfgaard deck. At the beginning we have been attacked by Uber Urka, who doesn't give us a chance to attack back. And all we have to do is to wait until he gets tired. That's not all. Further dies often. If we distracted by interesting level design or birds or dreams of good games or dreams of good life beyond Russian borders, Fjodor will kick the bucket. Throughout of this level, Бралгин gets shot by archers and their arrows are not disappear because it's funny. And in the end, game says us that we need to protect Fjodor and die with honor.
Fjodor, все ништяк! Еще километра три и у него бензин закончится!
Федор, не торопись, я его угомоню!
Бросай!
Slavic fantasy humor that you will never understand. Finally, last level where we need to play by Kigdalf. Our main enemy and target, Mr. Bandarlog, who strong as Soviet army, but stupid as Soviet government, except for Saint Iosif Stalin. Our special Kigdalf's magic stick can damage Bandarlog, but there is a little problem. The charges are over, and we must find more, running through level full of real aesthetic пиздец. After two shots in Ebala of Bandarlog, we may see adaptation of famous scene.
Пендальф, ну как ты там? Блин, хорош топать, идиот, мозг сломаешь! Пендальф, вот моя женщина! Текайте, хлопцы, I'll be back.
This is the end of my nerve system. Kigdalf and Ghost of Communism are not dead. They fell on the battle ring, where our fate will decide it. First of all, I don't know how to beat him. There is no damage even with magic police stick. The fact is that solution is not obvious. We must shot Bandarlog only when he growls, because at that moment fire do not protects him. But it's not easy. His growls catapult us into the void. After an hour of acrobatic tricks, I killed him and game ended. Yep, without any afterword. What I can say about that masterpiece? Well, it's not. This is just weird copy of the Return of the King game. I know that there are a few previous Lord of the Ring games with same gameplay, but developers do not. But if won't pay attention to this, you can have a lot of fun, except you're not hardcore fan of Tolkien or Tolkien himself. In this case, you'll die by nuclear butt-plosion. If this video is acceptable for you, please like, and I will tell you about next game, Two Mad Towers, which is oh god. That's all for today, my friends. Bye.